I've beaten the game 3 times on the hunt to my platinum trophy and finally found the build that turns Lies of P into easy mode. Some battles get completely trivialized. Others that seem hard before you're like, why did I ever struggle? Most important, since the Saintess of Mercy statue exists, every one of you can just straight up try this out for 10, 20 golden fruit. Let me show you the weapons, locations, the formula to allocate your stats for this build, but it's also applicable for any other build, and also which organs did I choose, so you can have a no frustration, super fun playthrough. I played through the whole game using 3 different weapons and leveling all 3 up to plus 10. That is the Salamander Dagger Blade, Acidic Crystal Spear, and also the Electric Coilstick Head. You get all of these in the first 2 to 3 hours of the game already, and for the next 30, you need nothing else. And it's gonna be the right tool for the job. May I present you Knife on a Stick, which goes stab, stab, stabity, stab, 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 stabity, stab. Very efficient with a double stab as well. The best part, boom. That's bonus fire damage and almost immediately sets everything on fire. This will trivialize every encounter with petrified opponents because they're vulnerable versus fire damage. Every petrified zombie, the elites, everything, they have slow wind-up attacks, but you just walk up to them, 1, 2, 3, then you might have to dash one back, and you can go for double stab, and you're getting them staggered so fast, and they'll burn over time. Best is if you also use your puppet string, and yes, that also applies and helps you to get the fire on even faster, especially when you're burning and your puppet stringing in. Well, hello there. Get knocked down because you're an idiot. The second weapon is the electric coilstick head that I'm pretty much using for the first 3 to 4 acts and then later on again. That one also gets put on the acidic crystal spear handle. Now, I've seen some people mention that it has a little bit less damage when you turn it into a stabbing weapon. That doesn't matter at all because your scaling is the advanced scaling. You're not having motivity or technique scaling. Having the advanced scaling going on. But don't worry about that all too much. And this gets turned into stabby max stab phase. Yes, you essentially have the perfection stabber to just take puppets out. You can increase your electric damage to straight up deal electric damage. If you want to, you could also charge up for a big hit. Coolest part is that even the charge is just stabbing right into the nuts. That works against puppets so great. Later in the game, there will be the electric chainsaw. The electric chainsaw allows you to turn this more into a side swiping weapon. So if you like this a little bit more, if this agrees a wee bit more with your playstyle, it can be nice, especially this one does stagger quite a lot. And if you pair this then with the puppet string, it does nicely work together, especially because it's a bit slower and just hurts a bit harder feelingly. Now, the third weapon into the fray is the acidic crystal spear. And why would you need the spear itself? Well, that is again with the acidic crystal spear handle against human opponents. As soon as you start facing alchemists and human bosses too, no puppets, no monsters, the petrified human kind of beings. Then you have something to acid the people, especially with Vup, you do even more acid damage. You know, the Black Rabbit Brotherhood, they don't like acid at all. Yeah, I mean, who wants to get acid poked? Same movement set of all the weapons, essentially. Now, first, let's go on with stats and organs, and then I'll tell you the locations of all 3 weapons. Right now, I'm level 79 with 28 vitality, vigor, capacity, and advance. The way how I leveled this up is I put 1 point in vitality, capacity, and advance, then another point in vitality, capacity, and advance. Always start with vitality though, and then 1 point in vigor, because vigor is important but not that important compared to the others. So do 1 1 1 1 1 1 and then 1 in vigor. Why is capacity so high? There is quite some amulets that take, this is 10 weight, right? You see, I'm always around 56 weight. The good thing that my blade is not that weighty. I mean, right now I would love to put on another 12 weight amulet, But that would make me slightly heavy, and I really dislike playing in any slightly heavy state. The most important one I'm using is the Nameless Ones amulet. You get this for killing a boss and trading this in for their soul. Has a chance of none being consumed when using pulled cells. That gives you, instead of 9 pulled cells, up to 13, 14, sometimes even 15 pulled cells in total if needed. And you can see here, I'm essentially playing the most weightiest frames, the biggest resistance converter, and also the biggest break cartridge. Therefore, I kind of need my capacity to be up high that I don't get overburdened quickly. Now, in order to show you P organs, I guess let's just respec them and do them live for you. From phase one, two big nodes you desperately want to have: increased pull cells and a link dodge. Link dodge is if you don't want it perfectly timed and you want to have a double dodge roll ability, quite useful. The first thing, item type. Increase ergo up and eliminating an enemy. I mean, after your first quartz, you continuously just get more ergo for killing perfection. Then enhance charge stagger attack. So your charge attacks do stagger harder and you get people better in that groggy state. Then for the link dodge, I like to go for the enhance the fatal attack because we're now staggering even harder. So if you then have your fatal attack when they are groggy, do more damage, super combination, and also lower charge attack stamina consumption because we're charge attacking, we're using less stamina, we're doing more damage, works everything together. For the next one, you want increased pulled cells again and also the amulet swap, 100%. Here we can go now for phase two upgrades already. And usually I would say special grindstone increase effect duration, but we're not using the special grindstone at all because we are elemental damaging the whole time. Here, reducing the stamina consumption from a dash, if you have to dash, is really useful to never run out of stamina. And also enhancing the pull cell recovery is extremely important, or you'll end up with not healing enough for the respective amount of HP you have. Then enhanced perfect guard destruction is important if you're actually perfect guarding a lot, which you should be, because in a lot of fights that's useful, and it just helps you to stagger bosses faster and essentially also get their weapons destroyed faster. Which brings me also to enhances resistance to attribute and status ailments. Can be useful, but with the right resistors, you don't really need it. But also lowering the damage of charge attack and fable arts can be good. I usually go with attribute resistance though. Phase three is super important. You want to get there as soon as possible for, again, the pulled cell recovery, so you're not left in the water, because else the minimal recovery is just so annoying. It also gives us straight away another pulled cell so we can heal more, even more ergo up in eliminating enemies so we can level harder, and on top the fable arts effect duration, the fire, the lightning, and yes, the acid as well is just holding longer. Now if you're using the cube, this one could be useful, but I don't actually use the cube. So what I would rather do here is either increase the staggerable window, which is useful, or just add another fable slot so you can charge up to 4 fable slots, which is really useful. And here you can go for enhanced charge stagger attack because your charge is so easy to do. And also lower weapon durability consumption when weight increases. That one is so good because you get heavier and heavier and your weapon breaks easier. Saves you quite some pain. Now we're in phase four, and there we can add another amulet slot straight away. Perfect guard stiffness is super good as well. Special grindstone uses, if you're playing a motivity build, I 100% went for that for the double elementals. And the fable slot, all four of them are just fantastic to go for. But I start with amulet slot. And here it's straight lower weapon durability consumption, which goes also over to increases pulled cell. Huh. Now we're going all the way back to one, perfect guard, fable charge enhance. Whenever you perfect guarding, your fable charge enhance just gets higher. Now I only have 1 quartz left because this was a speed run. Usually I would have another 10 more quartzes. And here the very important one is auto charge pulse when discharged. Yes, your pulled cell automatically charges over time when discharged. No worries, for phase five, we get the other save. Yes, there's also phase six for NG pluses, but if you make it to phase five, there is a staggerable window increase, and there's also retain guard regain. Most important, you can increase fable art effect duration again, stagger duration, stagger attack from behind, and enhance fable attack. Get another pulled cell bonus straight away, but also the coolest one in existence, auto charge legion. Because yes, your legion gets charged all the way over and over again. Which brings us to your legion arm, and here the only one you want to have is the puppet string leveled all the way up to the attack link. And I get that roughly done by Act 5 to have the attack linked up, Barren Swamp. And from that point on, no elite will ever be a problem again, because you can pull yourself in, jump up, slash him down, follow up with a double stab of your weapon, and straight away have them more or less staggered already for your Fable attack. Later, the Alchemist opponents, they're actually an issue. There are no issues anymore. You'll just roll them. Now, there's a slight spoiler coming now, because I wanted to show you how good the blade, for example, is in the beginning. This is going to be one of the early boss fights. If you don't want to see how to beat him, skip this. Straight up to the weapon locations. But here, we're actually fighting against Bishop Andreas. And you can see how the stabbing dagger just allows me to go bop, bop, bop. But most important, since you're attacking so fast, and yes, the dagger right now with the dagger hilt is attacking even faster a little bit with the acidic spear handle, but not very much. The good thing is, though, I can stab and straight up go into the block. Stab guard. So with other weapons, you would be like still at the end of your swing, still stuck in the swing, and you can do this. So even if he goes for a upper down, you perfect guard, stab once. Then he goes again, perfect guard, stab, stab again. Goes a side sway, perfect guard, stab, stab, stab. You can continuously just give him hell and burn him down. And that theme continues throughout the whole game. You just completely overwhelm and obliterate your opponent. The Salamander Dagger can be found as soon as you're in the Union Workshop. You activate the Stargazer, walk up the stairs, fall down the trapdoor, boom, that's it. There it is. Straight up, like, that's an hour or two into the game. And before that, before you even get there, to beat the whole Union Workshop, at the Elysian Boulevard Stargazer, on top in the house, that you can't miss because you gotta go there. Vendor that sells you the electric coil for 1,200 ergo. And from that point on, you're just gonna use this. And yes, you can put the dagger handle to make that an even faster electric stabbing craziness as soon as you have it. After you kill Bishop Andreas, there's the next Stargazer. You walk down the path. Here's one of these doggies with a waving arm and a dude breaking a box. Walk down that corridor and you'll find already the acidic crystal spear. That's it. All three weapons you need. Keep upgrading them. Go to the receptionist and Hotel Crod for more moonstones to upgrade them even further. Focus on electricity and fire first. Acid is for later, for Act 9, 10, 11. Ladies and gentlemen, enjoy your playthrough. Less frustration. What are you going for? Technique, motivity, what weapons are you using? Share with us. If you're now looking for special boss weapons, check out this video, or in general, the best S-tier scaling magic weapons, because there's the one or the other you can also get in the late game. That's for you.